Hi everybody, I'm Mike DeHeal, your gut guy, and in this video we're going to talk about are antibiotics safe? Is it okay to take oral antibiotics, IV antibiotics? Because there's a lot of confusion in both the modern and holistic medicine community. And the truth is, when I was healing my gut from Crohn's and colitis, I had my modern GI doctor, you know, he had me on antibiotics for a whole entire year at some point. And, you know, Flagyl is not fun. Makes everything taste like garbage. It ruins your taste buds and stuff like that. And it wasn't doing much for my symptoms. But there are also cases where if someone doesn't take antibiotics, they will die. And I'm not exaggerating. If there are too many microbes in the gut creating toxins and byproducts, it's too much stress on the system. You know, someone who's very underweight, they're listening to their holistic mentors and stuff like, oh, it's going to make your gut health issues worse. Don't take it. And, you know, it can be very dangerous where just simply taking an antibiotic can make a world of difference for somebody going through a lot of pain. So in this video, I'm going to clear up some of the confusion behind antibiotics and show you how to use them correctly. Because modern medicine and holistic medicine, they both aren't using them correctly. We're going to look at how antibiotics interact with the body from a German New Medicine perspective. And German New Medicine is what I used to heal my gut for good so that I can eat anything that I want. I suggest that you eat healthy foods, but I can literally eat whatever I want. This morning, I know this is gonna hurt a lot of you to hear this, but I had like chicken nuggets and Coke for breakfast. Why? Because that's what was in the fridge, okay? And I'm fine, I had a perfectly formed stool, and it was great, and I look great. Whereas when I was on these, you know, when I was on drugs, when I was on trying holistic things and trying diets and, you know, I tried natural antibiotics, I tried probiotics, I was still very skinny. I was 155 pounds, severely underweight. And that's 155 pounds isn't severely underweight, but I didn't look good. And now I weigh easily 185 pounds. I don't try very hard to keep this weight on, and I think I look pretty good. And I feel good, most importantly. So antibiotics, and if you want my free guide on how to do this, it's in the description. It comes in a PDF and a video format, and I show you how to do everything you need. But watch this video, and as you watch this video, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. This can literally save somebody's life. It can save lives, just this one little act that you're doing, because this will promote me in the algorithm. Stay and watch the whole video. Watch time is the most important thing. It's also going to bring you benefits because you're going to know how to use antibiotics for your kids and your friends and for yourself. This is very important stuff to know. Your health is your most important asset. And you can give this gift to somebody else by hitting the like button and leaving a comment. I read all my comments. I love to give helpful feedback. And your feedback, really, you want to roast me? Roast me. I love hearing your guys' feedback because it helps me deliver the message clearer to you guys so I know what you guys need to hear in order to get better. So let's look at this from the holistic medicine community first, because a lot of people, you know, most of my audience, you know, there is this holistic mindset where antibiotics are the devil. Antibiotics are the devil, and you know, they caused all my gut issues. Those are devil horns, by the way. Antibiotics are the devil. Even the creator of antibiotics said that these bacteria and fungi become antibiotic resistant in just a short little time, et cetera, et cetera. I didn't have gut issues until I started taking antibiotics. Is that true? Because I didn't take antibiotics until I had gut issues. And, you know, I'll be honest, you know, antibiotics did help me for a certain amount of time. But there's something that holds more weight in this equation. As you watch this video, I'm going to share with you things that you've never heard before. So please keep an open mind, because it will change your life. So the first fact I want you to be aware of, and please be open to this statement, is that most people take antibiotics on a yearly basis and they don't have autoimmune issues. They don't have severe symptoms like a lot of us do, or did for me. So for example, my mom, my brothers, my dad, my grandma, my grandparents, my friends, they take antibiotics on a yearly basis. Yes, they do. They do. Most people take antibiotics on a yearly basis. And they don't suffer from digestive issues. They don't have like these severe health issues. And most of these people, they don't take probiotics. Like they don't have yogurt. They don't take a probiotic supplement. You know, all their food is cooked. You know, they're not replacing the microbiome. You know, they have no symptoms. They do not have probiotics, yet they don't suffer from a lot of gut issues. And they do this for years. They do this their whole, my mom and my dad, they've been doing this their whole life. They don't have any gut issues. Now, to help us understand why this is, and on the flip side of this, I've seen people in the holistic community for you know, the past 5 or 10 years, you know, they've been really ingrained in the holistic community, and they take lots of probiotics, they take lots of natural disinfectants, they take lots of antibiotics, they do this for years, and they still have a messed up gut microbiome, they still have symptoms. So what this tells us, from a logic standpoint, is that taking probiotics and antibiotics aren't that important. That there's something bigger at play. Well, they are important in certain, and especially antibiotics can be very important in certain occasions. So for example, you know, I had a friend who had a UTI infection, and they were suffering immensely. They couldn't get out of bed for like 2 or 3 days because they were part of the holistic mindset. They were like, oh, I'm not taking antibiotics. They're the devil, da 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 da. And I'm like, okay, yeah, sure. All right, do that. And like literally the pain became too much. They went to the doctor. They got an antibiotic. You know, they were supposed to take the antibiotic for 2 weeks. They took the antibiotic for literally a few days and they were fine. Gone. Fine. And just because they took the antibiotic for like a couple of days. And I'll explain why this is. You don't have to do the whole course. It's up to you what you want to do. But you will learn how to use antibiotics more intelligently when you understand what's going on behind the scenes. So this is more for people with gut issues, but it can also apply to other issues as well, other conditions as well. So for people with gut issues, in German New Medicine, gut issues are caused by an indigestible morsel conflict, an indigestible thing in their life conflict. So for example, for me, I was horrible with women. I couldn't attract women. I couldn't keep them attracted to me when we get into relationships. So I was like constantly digesting women. And so what my body did was, you know, I got broken up with or something in high school, you know, got my little heart trampled on, and I just became obsessed with women behavior and stuff like that. And so my gut went, okay, we're going to develop extra gut cells to help you digest women. And so extra gut cells started to form. And you can see this, you can see rings in the brain on people who have this. And then when this gets resolved, and this would get resolved by getting a girlfriend or something like that, or making up after a fight with a girlfriend or something like that, and then the body goes, okay, I don't need these extra gut cells anymore, and it starts to get rid of them. And it starts to get rid of them with the help of bacteria and fungi. So bacteria and fungi are ripping away at this extra flesh we no longer need anymore. And that causes symptoms. If somebody takes probiotics during this time, that means there's going to be more bacteria and fungi ripping away at your flesh. And it's going to hurt more. If you take antibiotics during this time, that means there will be less bacteria and fungi ripping away at your flesh, and it will decrease the symptoms. And there is a similar process to this going on other organs, depending on how you and your biology and your like how your brain and how your personality interprets the conflict shock. Someone could get broken up with and they're digesting the situation. Someone could get broken up with and they feel like a fish out of water. They feel like a refugee. They feel abandoned, and that starts the kidney collecting tubules. And it does the exact same thing. The body retains water, and then they start to put on weight. And then when it gets resolved, it breaks down that extra tissue in the kidneys, and they have like a kidney infection because the bacteria and fungi are breaking down the extra tissue in the kidneys. So there's a decision to be made. I would like to get rid of these extra gut cells, but it hurts so bad, I can't see straight. You know, some doctors will be like, hey, take antibiotics for 3 months, see what happens. In reality, you know, you only need to take antibiotics for, you know, until things become bearable again. And it depends on the situation. If someone's very skinny and it looks like they're about to die, they probably need more because they literally can't handle all this self-mutilation. But if someone's more healthier, they got a lot of weight on them, like, okay, all right, I can put up with the suffering. It's not that bad. You know, I got some meat on my bones. I'm good. Only you can make this decision. But only you can make this decision if you have the correct knowledge. If you have the knowledge of a holistic nutcase person, and I used to be that way, I'm not making fun of you guys. If you have the holistic knowledge, you're going to make a bad decision because you're not seeing the real thing that's going on. And most importantly, if you are centered on, in the holistic community, it's all about getting your gut microbiome right. My gut microbiome, it's my second brain. The gut microbiome, it digests my food. The gut microbiome, it does everything. My gut microbiome, I'm sick of hearing, I want to puke every time someone says, the gut microbiome. It's really, who knows how important it is? I don't know how someone can make sense out of all this, but you know, there are people who are abusing their gut microbiome every single day, you know, multiple times a year, and they're fine. And then there's people who are babying their microbiome like a helicopter mom, and they are miserable. They are underweight. They can't eat anything, and they're not getting better. And they're spending thousands of dollars on soil-based probiotics, spore-based probiotics, shooting shit up, you know, like literally, they do fecal matter plant transplants. There's people who eat shit. It's ridiculous the things that they do to try to manage their gut microbiome. But in reality, what's causing what is in control of the bacteria and fungi in your gut, it's more your brain. They're made by your own cells. These bacteria and fungi are made by your own cells. And so what Dr. Hammer, the founder of German New Medicine, saw is that if someone had a sharp ring in their brain, you know, this is specifically for gut issues, if someone had a sharp ring, someone had cell proliferation going on, building up extra gut cells. And then when the conflict got resolved, the ring would be washed out, and then the bacteria and fungi start to peel away the bacteria. Peel away the flesh. We see this on a microscope. These bacteria and fungi come out of our own cells. Here's another thing to throw a wrench in the holistic nonsense in the modern medical community, infection theory. So someone will have an infection in their small intestine, you know, and then they won't have an infection in their large intestine. How is that possible with that theory? Because doesn't everything flow downstream? If there's an infection here, should it flow all this should be infected because it's going to flow downstream. Where in reality, it's not like that. It's always sections. It's either a little patch here, then a little patch here, then a little patch here. And Dr. Homer, depending on where these inflammation patches and where these infection patches were, he would see a specific part of the brain light up with these rings. And so the ultimate thing you can do to fix your gut microbiome is to address these emotional issues, to address these emotional conflicts that are causing the cell proliferation and cell loss. And the way that antibiotics factor into this is when you're in a healing phase, when you have a fever, when you're going through a flare, you've resolved something, and you might want to consider taking antibiotics to help the pain. That's it in its simplicity. There's a lot of people, my gut issues didn't start until I started taking antibiotics. Like, I used to say this too, but please get serious with yourself. You didn't take antibiotics until you were in pain. You started taking antibiotics because you were in pain, you had a lot of symptoms. And those symptoms originated from a conflict shock that got resolved and started this whole thing. This is what is really happening here. This can also be triggered by perceiving foods as hard to digest. That's a whole nother conversation, which I have in my free 30-day guide. It's in a video and in a PDF format. But having this knowledge is essential to using antibiotics correctly. Antibiotics work amazing. So after World War I, we did not have antibiotics, and people were getting a lot of lung infections because they were recovering from a scare fright conflict. So lots of people died of lung tuberculosis and flus and stuff like that. They just died because, you know, they're probably malnourished from the war, super weak, super, you know, the diets weren't as plentiful, you know, the foods weren't as good back, you know, depending on where someone lived, you know, someone's diet could really suffer, you know, underweight and stuff like that. So the antibiotics weren't there to help manage someone's symptoms. And, you know, they just died. You know, the Spanish flu that happened right after World War I, it's the resolution of scare fright conflicts or territorial fear conflicts. And in World War II, the same thing happened. They had this big tuberculosis outbreak and flu outbreaks, but it was better managed because, well, we had better medical technology. And a big hero of that medical technology was the antibiotics. Antibiotics save lives, guys. Don't let the holistic modern medical community, block that from you. Take that from you. It's an amazing tool. But again, if you have a saw, it's a great tool. But if you don't use it right, you could saw off your own arm. Or you could save yourself hours of work or... shit, you can't even do many jobs without a saw. So it's a very important tool, but let's use it correctly. Let's understand what's going on. Please watch this video right here. Please watch my 30-day guide. I've seen so many people get better from it. Leave a comment. No, go watch this. You should have already left a comment. Go watch this right now. As you watch this video, guys, you will get better, and you'll do it enjoyingly. You'll be able to eat your favorite foods again. You won't have to go on crazy diets and all that fun stuff. I'm Mike the Healer Gut Guy. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.